Today we're going to see how you can remove an object from a photo and also to fix a photo if it has some imperfections that you want to eliminate. In this photo we have a backpacker standing on a cliff. Let's pretend that you just want the scene but you don't want him. The first thing you need to do is to hit the duplicate button before we do anything. Because what you're going to find, if you've done any Photoshop, you're probably familiar with this too, the background layer is locked. And so you want to create a layer that you can work with. So I'm going to right click on background and then hit duplicate. And that will duplicate the layer that I'm going to be using. Now, some of you might have, might know keyboard shortcuts and all that stuff. I will be the first to admit that I am not great with keyboard shortcuts, so I hardly ever use them, so I don't know them, and so I generally am wedded to the mouse probably for life. Now, the tool we need to get rid of this guy is called the inpainting tool, but if you scroll down to find it, you won't find it. And the reason is because it's hidden, and it's hidden behind this tool that's called the healing brush tool. So in order to look for it, you're going to have to hit this this tiny little arrow, and you will see that you have the inpainting brush tool, which is the one that we want. So if you hit the inpainting brush tool, then you'll find that you get this circle right here, and you want your settings to be set a little bit differently than they show up here. What I want in my pixels is going to be 65 pixels, and that will make this circle bigger. Then we want the hardness to be 100%. And opacity and flow and all that stuff are going to be the same. So since we changed from 45 pixels to 65 pixels, notice that this little circle right here that we're going to be using is a little bit bigger. Now, what we're going to do now is, since we have everything selected, make sure everything is the way you want it, that you have the correct layer selected, which is background, because if you don't, if you have the other one selected, then you're going to find that this thing won't do a thing. So now we're going to click on our mouse, and we're just going to paint over this guy. Like this. Make sure we get all of him, and, you know, be okay. So this isn't going to be perfect, so now we're going to let go, and you'll notice here that it's thinking about it, and the guy is gone. So like magic, this guy is now gone. Okay, now on this one, when I got this picture from Pixabay, so if you want to get pictures to practice on your own, Pixabay is a good site to use because all the pictures are free. When I got this one, for this particular exercise, I got one where the background was more monochromish, that there wasn't a lot of busyness in the background. But then I decided that maybe I wanted to see what would happen if the background were a little bit more busy. So we're going to pull in another picture, and we're going to see what happens if we use something else. So I'm going to close this. I'm not going to save it. And then I'm going to file and open, and I'm going to try this other backpacker. This time the backpacker has a lot of stuff around him, grass, the trail, the mountains, and all that stuff. Now, since we're just starting Affinity Photo 2, I was convinced that that was just a simple way of getting rid of objects that we're standing on, like a monochrome background, and that it's a little bit more complicated. So I wanted to see that. Now remember, we've got to duplicate this background layer because it's not going to let you use it. So go up here and duplicate it and make sure that background layer is selected, and it is. And so we're going to go down here, and the in painting brush tool is already selected because we already selected it for the last picture, and it's going to stay that way until we change it. So we will make sure that it's selected. Everything that we had before is going to be what we had in the last picture. And then on this, we'll click on the mouse and paint over this guy and see if it looks a little bit more strange since you don't have a monochrome background. So then it will think about it, and he's gone. Now, right here, what it did is it left a little bit of the trail. So all you'd really need to do is to paint over it or click on it, because the circle is completely rounded. I just clicked on it and it got rid of the trail. And now it looks like that the guy was never there. So in my opinion, for simple things like this, this works pretty well if you've got photos that you want to alter and you just want to get rid of something that's in the photo and make it into something else. Okay. Now, but of course, I'm guessing that if something gets a little bit more complicated, that it won't work as easily as this did, but I'm sure I'm going to find out sooner or later as my Affinity journey continues. Here, I've pulled in another picture. And in this photo, what we want to do is to remove blemishes from this woman's face. Now remember, the first thing you need to do is to duplicate the layer so that you don't forget about it. The reason I keep saying that is because I always forget about it. And then I run around panicking because I wonder what I did wrong and why I can't get anything to work. So we are going to right-click on my mouse, hit duplicate, and now we have a duplicated layer. So we have the original background and we have the duplicated layer. We're going to use the same tool for this one, the in painting tool. So we're going to go down here and make sure it's selected. Here's the in painting brush tool, which is, of course, with this group. So in painting brush tool. It was selected because all I did was close the last picture, so it kept all those settings from before. Now, on this one, we want to make some alterations up here to the contextual toolbar. A few changes. And so the one thing I want to do is I want to change the hardness to 50%. So I'll select it and type in 50, and that will change the hardness to 50%. I want to make the width a little bit smaller too, because look how big it is. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be clicking on the blemishes on this woman's face. And since it's going to try to match the background, if you do this, we want to make it as accurate as possible. So I'm going to change this 65 pixels to 45 pixels and then see how that lines up over here. And that looks pretty good as far as me clicking on the pictures and trying to fix her face. Now, what we'll do is all you do here, this is pretty easy. All you want to do is to select and click on the blemish that you want to get rid of. So we'll click on that one and it gets rid of it. Click on this one, get rid of it, and there. And how far you want to go on this kind of depends on, I guess, a natural look. So I'm just clicking around on these and seeing how many I can get rid of. Okay, we'll go down there on her chin and another one on her chin and so on. Now, if you're clicking on these and you want to see what the before and after pictures look like, all you have to do is to go over here and click on this dot, and it's called toggle visibility. So click on the dot and it will show you what the original one looks like, the background that's locked, and click on it again and that will show you what your new picture looks like. So basically, you just fiddle around with it until you get, you know, the way that you want it to get. And toggle again for as a comparison and so on. So that is all you have to do as far as fixing imperfections on a picture or fixing imperfections on someone's face. So now we are at the end of the whole lesson. I hope you got something out of it and that you continue with me on the Affinity Photo 2 ride. I'm going to try to put out a video a week to keep some consistency. And so I remember all this myself, because if I don't do this every week, I will stop doing it, and then I won't remember what I did at first and all that stuff. So I'm trying to stick to a video a week. And I'm also still working on my serial killer series. So, of course, that's on the horizon too. So remember to like and subscribe and ring that notification bell so you can stay in the loop and help my channel grow.